In this quick video, you will learn how to create a bootable flash drive on any Linux system using the native Linux tools. Hello everyone, it's Sachin, Linux user, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. I know that many of you are scared of the Linux command line, but believe me, you will benefit so much if you learn the Linux command line tools. For example, if you need to make a bootable USB flash drive. Different distributions provide different graphical programs to do that, but every Linux distribution has the same built-in tool to do the same job. You just need to learn one simple command. This command is dd. It works pretty simple. You type this command, where sudo means to give admin privileges to this command. Dd is the program name. Bs equal 4m means to use block size of 4 megabytes. So the system will read and write the data in chunks of 4 megabytes. This option is simply meant to speed up the process. If specifies the source to read, this is an ISO file of the Linux image you download from the Linux distribution website. I downloaded Arch Linux installation image. Off specifies the destination, where to write this ISO file. In other words, it is your USB drive. And this is the most important part of the command. If you do a mistake here, you can screw up your whole system, so be very, very careful. DevSDX means the name assigned to the device by your Linux system. It is some kind of analogy of disk C, D, and E in Windows systems. To find out the name Linux assigned to your flash drive, open a new tab by pressing Ctrl+Shift+T and type sudo fdisk with option L. Then you need to analyze this output. Usually the USB devices are listed at the end. You find your flash drive by its size, and it also usually has only one partition. I know that my flash drive is 15 gigs, so its name is SDD. This name is not permanent, and it depends on the order the drives are mounted to the system. So you need to check your USB drive name every time you insert it into your computer. Now you need to go back to the DD command and change the X to D. The option status equal progress is not necessary, but it is helpful because it will show the progress during the write process. Without this option, nothing will be printed on the terminal screen. Sync is actually another command, not an option. Sync clears the cache. And these signs mean it will be executed as the chain is DD. This will make sure that all the data is written to the flash drive and nothing is left in the cache. I also need to warn you that this procedure will wipe all the data from your USB flash drive. So if you have any important data on it, copy it somewhere else before you run this command. When you are sure that there is no valuable data on your flash drive, and you specified all the names correctly, especially the off option, press enter. This will write the ISO file to the flash drive. It usually takes several minutes to complete. When the process is finished, you can reboot your system and boot from the newly created bootable USB. After you have used the bootable USB flash drive and installed Linux system, you need to restore your flash drive back to its normal state. To do that, you need to remove the bootable system from it. Run sudo wipefs with option O devsdd, where again sdd is my flash drive name. You can check it with sudo fdiskl. After that, create a new partition on it, type sudo cfdisk and the device name, select DOS, press enter to create a new partition, keep it at its maximum size, press enter again to make it primary, navigate with arrow keys to write, and press enter to write the changes. Type yes to confirm, and quit the program. Run sudo fdiskl to check if the new partition has been created. And as you can see, yes, the new partition named sdd1 is here. Format this partition as FAT file system, where LU is the label I give to this drive, you can use your name instead. And sdd1 is the partition name. Unlike in all the previous steps, where we use the device name, here we need to specify the partition name, which ends with the number. After these uncomplicated steps, your flash drive is like new, and you can use it to store files. Now you know how to make a bootable USB flash drive on any Linux system. Please give a like to this video if it was useful. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching.